Welcome, everyone. We begin by acknowledging that this event takes place on the ancestral territory of the Puyallup tribe and the Lushootseed-speaking people, whose relationship with the land continues to this day. We respectfully acknowledge and honor the history and presence of Indigenous students, staff, and faculty here at Puget Sound. We, who are guests on this land, offer our gratitude for the opportunity to make music together here. The School of Music strives to recognize, include, and respect all of the peoples and musical traditions that make up our community.
Thank you.
everyone. Thank you so much for being here this weekend. We are so happy to be playing this program for you tonight. By way of introducing the pieces, I thought it might be interesting to tell you a little bit about why and how I chose this particular program. So for me, planning a concert program, it's a little like planning a multi-course meal. So I usually like to start with like one dish or a piece, and then the rest of the meal kind of evolves from there. You know, you want to have variety, balance, sometimes maybe some kind of a theme, and you want to leave your guests pleasantly full. So the Mozart you just heard was like a little appetizer. And it's, you know, something familiar to awaken your palate to the rest of the evening. So the dish that I wanted to make for this particular program and that inspired the rest of the meal that you're going to hear tonight was actually the Amy Beach Violin Sonata, which you're going to hear on the second half. It's a beautiful, stormy, virtuosic, and pretty massive work that demands a lot from both the violinist and the pianist. In thinking about what to pair it with, I found myself thinking about the relationship of composers to performers. Amy Beach was an American composer, and she, in fact, in her time, she really was one of the most influential American composers of her day. She was also a virtuosic pianist, and she performed often in recital with the American violinist Maude Powell. Beach even dedicated one of her violin and piano pieces to Powell, The Romance for Violin and Piano. And that's a piece that I very much love to play. I've played it a lot and was a main reason why I wanted to play this violin sonata tonight. So Powell was certainly very influential to Amy Beach in helping Beach shape her writing for the violin. Powell was also a champion of another groundbreaking composer of the day, the African-British composer Samuel Coleridge Taylor. Coleridge Taylor actually met Powell in London, and then he subsequently wrote his violin concerto for Maude Powell. She premiered the violin concerto in the United States in the spring of 1912. Kind of an incidental, not super related to this program fact, but I think it's interesting. The premiere was delayed for the violin concerto because the score and the parts to the concerto were aboard a very famous ship that sank in April of 1912. Yeah, it was the Titanic, right? So the score and parts went down with the Titanic and it had to be reprinted and the premiere was delayed and happened a little bit later than was originally planned. So Maude Powell was a champion of Coleridge Taylor's music, and Coleridge Taylor faced enormous prejudice as a black musician in the early 20th century. And Powell helped break down a few of those barriers that Coleridge Taylor was facing by being the very first person to perform and record Coleridge Taylor's setting of the African spiritual Deep River in 1911. So the suite of pieces that you'll hear today was written by Coleridge Taylor when he was just 17 years old. You can already hear his skillful writing for the violin and his beautiful lyricism in this music. So Maude Powell, violinist, is the connection between Amy Beach and Samuel Coleridge Taylor. And similarly, another female concert violinist named Yeli Dalragi was the inspiration for Maurice Ravel's concert work, Cigan, which we'll close the first half with. Dalragi lived from 1893 to 1966, and she met Ravel at a house concert in 1922. She was performing his sonata for violin and piano. Ravel was so taken with her playing that he stayed up all night listening to her play Hungarian folk music on the violin. That's how the story goes, at least. And the next day, he began working on the piece that would later become Cigan. Dharangi was really no stranger to composers wanting to write for her. Bartok, Vaughan Williams, and Holst all dedicated pieces to her. Ravel chose to write a concert piece in the style of Hungarian folk music for Dharangi, and throughout the process he closely consulted with her about violin technique. So he completed the piece 2 years later in 1924, just 4 days before the premiere. She probably wasn't so happy about that, but it worked out. And in the piece, you'll not only hear echoes of folk music, but also the evocation of traditional Hungarian instruments like the cimbalom. So back to the concert planning. Amy Beach, Maude Powell, Samuel Coleridge Taylor, female violinists, inspiring composers, Yelena Dharangi and Ravel, and then Mozart was the appetizer. So I hope you enjoy the rest of the program, and Xiaowei and I will have our dinner after the concert.
Thank you. Thank you.